فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على البشير النذير، خاتم النبيين وإمام المرسلين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وعلى أتباعه ومن صار على نهجه وقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين وبعد. I wanted to inshallah share a موقف, a story. But as an introduction, I wanted to talk about the importance and how important it is that people have iman. Brothers and sisters, الإيمان ليس بالتحلي ولا بالتمني ولكنه ما وقر في القلب وصدقه العمل. Iman is not something you dress up with or you beautify yourself with. Iman is not a claim, a mere claim that you make. Rather, Iman is something that falls in your heart and then your actions say the truth about it. It is something that comes out of your heart and then it is seen on your limbs. It's seen on your body. الإيمان قول باللسان. The Iman is speech on the tongue. واعتقاد في القلب, a belief in the heart. وعمل الجوارح, and it's an action. والعمل بالجوارح, and an action on the limbs. That's what Iman is. You can claim as much as you want Iman, but if this is not found in you, then your Iman is not there. When, because of that, brothers and sisters, الإيمان له ثمرات عاجلة. The Iman has results that come quickly in this dunya. ينفع به ما أهله, and that it benefits the person who comes with it in the dunya and in the hereafter. The first one of it is, Allah promised those who come with Iman, who have it in their hearts, who say it on their tongue, who show it on their limbs. Allah Azza wa Jalla promised them in the Quran by saying, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, the ones that have found, be found in them in Iman. They have come with Iman, and they have Iman. And then Allah says, وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ. And then after that, they don't dress their Iman up with dhulm, oppression. And the dhulm here is meant by shirk. So they don't nullify their Iman. They don't come with anything that contradicts it, that goes against it, that distinguishes it. Allah then says, أُولَٰئِكَ, those people, لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ, those are the people who are going to receive success, safety. وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ, they are the ones that are guided. So once you have Iman, Allah is promising you subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's telling you that you will receive aman in this earth. You will find safety on this earth. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter who you're with. If real Iman is found in you, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give you al-aman. And Allah will give you amn. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you istiqra subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the person who comes with Iman, Allah promises her and him in this Quran, hayatun tayyiba, a good life. وَطُمَأْنِينَةُ الْقَلْبِ, and his heart or her heart is going to be in a state of tranquility. And this is not for anyone إلا لأهل الإيمان, except for the people of Iman. قال تعالى, Allah says in the Quran, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا, anyone who does a righteous actions, مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى, from the male and the female, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ حَالَ كَوْنِهِ مُؤْمِنًا, whilst he's in a state of Iman, فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ, we will give him a life, حَيَاةً, a life that is طَيِّبَةً, a great life, وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ, and we will reward him, أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ, his actions. Allah is saying subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ, we will reward him, أَجْرَهُمْ, the rewards, بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, from the goods that he used to do. So Allah is going to give him a good life in this world. Allah is going to make him or her, their heart, at a state of tranquility, طُمَأْنِينَةُ الْقَلْبِ. Allah also has promised them subhanahu wa ta'ala that in this dunya, Allah is going to take their righteous actions they have done, and in the hereafter, Allah will reward them for it. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, and they find in the verses and the remembrance of Allah their heart's tranquility. Ala bi dhikri Allah, oh people, in the remembrance of Allah, tatma'innu al-qulub, the remembrance of Allah, the hearts, they find tranquility. Walidhalika, some of the salaf and some of the pious predecessors, they used to say, and some of the ulama, they say, this was Ibrahim ibn Adham, the great alim, al-zahid, al-wari', he used to say, لو يعلم الملوك وابناء الملوك ما نحن فيه من النعيم والسرور لجادلونا عليه بالسيوف. He used to say, if the kings and the children of the kings were to know the ni'mah that we were upon, or the ni'mah that we are upon, and the joy in which we have, and the happiness that's in our heart, if the kings and the children of the kings were to know, they would have brought their swords out and they would come and try to take that away from us. They say he said this very powerful quote after he and his friend Abu Yusuf, they went together to the sea, and they both had two dry breads. Both of them had two dry bread, and they were dipping their bread into the sea, trying to find softness in their bread. So each and every one of them were dipping in. And Ibrahim ibn Adam looks at him and says this quote, لَا يَعْلَمُ الْمُلُوكُ وَأَبْنَاءُ الْمُلُوكِ مَا نَحْنُ فِيهِ مِنَ النَّعِيمِ وَالسُّرُورِ لَجَادَلُونَ عَلَيْهِ بِالسُّيُوفِ. If these kings and these rulers and their children were to know what we have in our hearts, the happiness, the ni'mah that we have, wallahi, they would take their swords out and they would come and they would want to take it away from us. What ni'mah is he talking about? What surur is he talking about? Wallahi innaha la ni'matul Islam. He's talking about the ni'mah of Iman and Islam. That's what made his heart at a state of tranquility. That is what put a smile on his face. The person who comes with Iman, shaitan has no power over him. Shaitan gives up on that type of person. Allah said in the Quran, innahu ay shaitan, laysa lahu sultanun, ay laysa lahu hujjah. He has no proof. He has no power. عَلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, the ones who believe. وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and depend on Allah. إِنَّمَا سُلْطَانُهُ, his power is over who? عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَتَوَلَّوْنَهُ, the ones that take him as an ally. The ones that follow his command. He glitters and shows the world to them and they follow the dunya. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِهِ مُشْرِكُونَ, and those who are polytheists with Allah and do shirk with Allah, those are the people shaitan takes over their brains. Shaitan controls them. He uses them. And even at times, shaitan looks at that person and he says to himself, I am more closer to Allah than you. كَمَثَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِذْ قَالَ لِلْإِنسَانِ اكْفُرْ فَلَمَّا كَفَرْ قَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Shaitan said, I fear Allah. Some people have reached that level of disobedience, of going against Allah's commands, of consistently sinning without any shame on their face or their hearts. And shaitan looks at that person and says, Subhanallah, you've passed my limits and my reach. I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who has Iman in their heart, who that Iman has settled in their heart as it should be, and then it shows on their tongue and their limbs, this is also what's being promised for them, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will defend him wherever he is and whoever he's with. Qala ta'ala, Allah says, إن الله الله يدافع عن الذين آمنوا. Allah defends and stands up for the dignity and the support of the righteous people. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, ألا إن أولياء الله, the allies of Allah, لا خوف, they have nothing to fear, ولا هم يحزنون, and they have no concern and no sorrow. الذين, they are those, آمنوا, who believed, وكانوا, and found in them was يتقون تقوى, piety. When Ali ibn Abi Talib was asked, what is meant by taqwa? He said a very powerful statement. He said that taqwa means al-amal bil-tanzil wal-rida bil-qalil wa-istidad al-yawm al-rahil. It's al-amal bil-tanzil. It's to act upon this kitab that came down. Wal-rida bil-qalil is to be pleased with the little Allah has given you, and not to run after this dunya, and to show yourself that you're in a place, there is nothing after it. كَلَّا ثُمَّ كَلَّا. No, wallahi, there are more to come. There are stages after this in which you're going to be questioned. Don't live in this dunya as though there's nothing going to come after it. The third one is, وَاسْتِعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ, to prepare for the Day of Judgment. To take the zad. تَزَوَّدْ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Take your provision with you. مِنَ الدُّنْيَا, from this dunya. What is it going to be? At-tuqa, piety. فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي إِذَا جَنَّ اللَّيْلُ هَلْ تَعِيشُ إِلَى النَّهَارِ. Because you don't know. If the dawn breaks, are you going to reach the afternoon? You don't know. These are things that have not been promised for you. إِذَا إِسْتَعِدُّوا لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ. To prepare for that day in which we're going to meet. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, on his deathbed, he started to cry. And they said to him, مَا يُبْكِيكَ يَا أَبَا هُرَيْرَةَ. What's making you cry? أنت صاحب رسول الله. You were the companion of the messenger. For your life you spent with him. فقال, he then answered by saying, Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, I am crying على قلة الزاد وطول السفر. I'm crying because of the small provision I have with me and the long journey that awaits me. A very long journey awaits me and I only have a little provision with me. Brothers, the people of Iman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them, Al-Ajr al-Azim wal-Bushra yawm al-Qiyamah. They have right, they have immense reward from Allah and they have glad tidings the day of judgment. Allah says in the Quran, وَسَوْفَ يُؤْتِ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Allah will give the right to people of Iman a great reward the day of judgment. This is what you receive once the Iman enters into your heart. It shows on your tongue and then it comes out on your limbs. Also Allah says in the Quran, وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Give glad tidings to the believers. They're the ones who deserve to be given glad tidings to. بِأَنَّ لَهُمْ for them is مِنْ اللَّهِ from Allah. Fadl and a virtue, kabir, and that is immense. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no ukhuwa, there is no brotherhood except through iman. As Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَى. Verily, the believers are brothers. The Messenger said in a hadith narrated by Bukhari and Muslim, الْمُسْلِمُ أَخُ الْمُسْلِمِ. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, المؤمن للمؤمن كالبنيان يشد بعضهم بعضا وشبك بين أصابعه. متفق عليه. That the believer to the other believer is like a building. They help each other, they strengthen each other. When the Prophet said that, he took his fingers and he slided them each on each other, as though they are strong and close and holding onto each other like this. Also he said, مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل جسد إذا اشتكى من عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. The believers are like one body for each other in terms of their love and their mercy and their compassion for each other. They are like that one body. If tonight your finger hurts you and you're not able to sleep, you won't sleep the whole night. The eyes have nothing to do with the finger, but because they're all the same body, you won't be able to sleep. This is how the Muslims are towards each other, and that's how their compassion is. There are those who claim Iman. Iman is something everyone claims. I'm a mu'min. But the reality is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا. From the people are those who say we're mu'mineen. وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرَةِ. We believe in the day of judgment. Allah then says, وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. They are not believers. They're liars. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ. They're deceiving Allah. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And the righteous people, the believers. وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ. Allah then says, they're not deceiving. They're not able to. Because they think they are, but they're not. وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ. They are not deceiving. إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Except themselves. وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ. But they don't feel it. They don't know it. They think they're fooling Allah and the believers. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah then says, why is this reason? فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضْ. In their heart is the illness. فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا. And Allah increased them in this illness. وَلَهُمْ. For those people are عَذَابٌ. A punishment. أَلِيمٌ. That is severe. بِمَا كَانُوا. بِسَبَبِ مَا كَانُوا. Because of the things كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. That they used to disbelieve in. Because of that they reached this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters, to see if we're true believers and to see what we claim is real and that this Iman has really entered into our hearts and that this Iman has really shown on our tongues and this Iman is really on our limbs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us to the test to see if it's true. Because claiming is easy. Saying I have this is easy. But when you're put to the test, if you pass, then everything will be clear. وَبِهِ تَتَمَيَّزُ الْأَشْيَاءِ. Then everyone will become clear. يميز الله الخبيث من الطيب. Allah distinguishes between who's the one that's sincere, the one that is righteous, the one that is steadfast. Who is that one? And the one who's lying about all of the things he claims. Allah says, أحسب الناس, have the people actually assumed, and يتركوا, they will be left, and يقولوا آمنا, for them to say, I believe, وهم لا يفتنون, and they won't be tested. This iman of yours, did you believe that you won't be tested for it? لا, ولقد فتن الذين من قبلهم. Allah tested those who came before you, Ya Muhammad. Allah tested those righteous people, those prophets and their followers who came. Allah tested them. Allah then says, فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا. Things will become clear. Who is the one who's true about it? وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ, and the one who lied about it. It will all become clear. Brothers and sisters, the believers, when these times come, you will tell who's the true believer. Who when the time of al-Rakha, the times of ease, his claim was true. The shiddah, this harm, when it comes on his face, he doesn't find any harm. He is steadfast, he's happy, he enjoys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's qadr and qada, what Allah has created for him. He is pleased with it. He has nothing to object against it. The munafiqeen, the hypocrites, when Allah and His Messenger creates something, and they write something, and they make something happen, they are not pleased with it. They are not happy. Rather, they have so much to say. As Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, the speech of the believers, the ones who iman have entered their hearts, إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, when they are called to Allah, وَرَسُولِهِ and His Messenger, لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ, for them to be judged by the Kitab and the Sunnah, يَقُولُ, and يقولوا, for them to say, سمعنا وهي وأطعنا, and we obey. وأولئك هم المفلحون. Those are the people who've reached success. As for the munafiqeen, they don't want to follow Allah's book. They don't want to follow the sunnah. All of it is just a claim, misclaim. Allah said in the Quran regarding them, ويقولون آمنا, they say we believe. وبالرسول, and we believe in the messenger. وأطعنا, and we obey. ثم يتولى, and then from them they turn away a group. منهم من بعد ذلك, after that. وما أولئك بالمؤمنين, wallahi those are not believers. وإذا دعوا إلى الله, when they are called to Allah and His Messenger, ليحكم بينهم, for them to be judged by it. إذا فريق منهم معرضون, a group of them will turn away. What's this religion? No, we don't want it. We're in the 21st century. No, this is old. We want a new religion. We want a religion that can go with the lifestyle that we live in. We want a religion that can goes with the technology and everything. كَلِمَةُ كُفْرٍ يُقَالُ, it's a speech of kufr that many people say. وَإِيَّكُمْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ. These people, if the haq came to them, they're not going to submit to it. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ, in their hearts is there an illness? أَمِرْتَابُوا, are they doubtful? أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ, بَلْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. They are scared. They don't believe what Allah is promising is going to happen. They think they're going to be destroyed with the Prophet and the righteous people. That's the munafiqeen. That's the hypocrites. The believers, brothers, they tell true about the mawaqif and their iman. They're true about it. They're steadfast. They don't move around. As Allah said in the Quran, وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. In the day of Ahzab, when the two armies came together and the fight was very serious, as Allah said, إِذْ جَاءُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ وَمِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَإِذْ زَاغَتِ الْأَبْصَارُ وَبَلَغَتِ الْقُلُوبُ الْحَنَاجِرَ وَتَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ الظُّنُونَ هُنَالِكَ ابْتُلِيَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَزُلْزِلُوا زُلْزَالًا شَدِيدًا. When this jihad, it was serious. People's eyes moved up. The heat, the pain and the suffering that came to them was immense. The people were two. Not a third, but a two. Only two groups. The true believers and the people who weren't true believers. Who weren't the believers at all. The hypocrites and the likes of them. The believers, when they saw the army, they looked at it, وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ, this is what Allah has promised us. This army that's coming our way, it's something Allah has promised us in the Quran. Many years, many months, we knew of it. We were aware of it. We were waiting for it. مَا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, وصدق الله ورسول الله and his messenger have said the truth. Allah then says, وَبَازَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. Nothing else increased in their heart except belief and submission to Allah. As for the munafiqeen, al-kadibin, the hypocrites, the liars, Allah says, وَإِذَا قُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. The munafiqeen, the hypocrites, they said, and those who had illnesses in their hearts, مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, Allah and His Messenger have not promised us except deception. They deceived us. وَإِذْ قَالَ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَا أَهْلَ يَثْرِبَ لَا مُقَامَ لَكُمْ فَارْجِعُوا. وَيَسْتَأْذِنُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمُ النَّبِيَّ يَقُولُونَ إِنَّ بُيُوتَنَا عَوْرَةٌ وَمَا هِيَ بِعَوْرَةٍ إِن يُرِيدُونَ إِلَّا فِرَارًا. I wanted to conclude by saying, this is a ni'mah that Allah has given you, ni'matul iman. As Allah said in the Quran, يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you show faith, you want to show it to look like a favor that you've done for Allah by taking iman. قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ. Do not try to show your favor to Allah by saying, oh Allah, I believed. بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ. But rather Allah is the one that's saying that I favored you in bestowing upon you and giving you iman if you're a true, trustworthy, true, truthful person. Allah has favored you with iman. Hold on to your iman. Follow what it orders you and stay away from what it prohibits you. Let iman be something you love and that it makes you steadfast and keeps you to the right path. As Allah said, وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانَ. Rather, Allah has made the iman more beloved to you and you love it. وَزَيِّرَهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ, and he beautified it in your hearts. Make the iman something that's beautified in your heart. Make the iman something you love. I want to conclude there. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.